There's two stocks that I bought really heavily this week, and they are gold mining companies. The first one is Barrick Gold, and the second one is KL. And why I bought heavily the stock? Well, I have five catalysts on them, and I will explain each point in details. First, what's the main thing that gold mining companies follow when they go up or down? Since they are stocks, they follow the market, and since they are gold mining companies, they follow the gold price. Usually when gold does 2-3% move, gold mining companies does 4-6% moves. So if you think about it, it's more leverage. First, I'm going to talk about two fundamental stuffs that's going on. And later in the video, I'm going to jump on the charts and explain some technical analysis. My first two catalysts is that gold mining companies are making much more profits than early 2020 and 2019. Later, I'm going to compare the gold price and gold mining prices, and you'll understand what I exactly mean by this. The second thing is that there was a report in China and India, physical gold sales increased more than 100%, which can affect the gold price. And if the physical gold sales increased much more, it means gold mining companies are selling more. My third catalyst is actually very simple, is that gold mining companies and gold price, they are oversold. It's been 6-7 months that gold is on a downtrend, which the mining companies followed them. As we said in the beginning, if gold price goes up 2-3%, gold mining companies can go 4-6%. But the same thing is that if gold drops, they will drop too. And my fourth catalyst is technical analysis. Now I'm going to jump on the charts of the stocks and you're going to understand more by what I mean. First, let's check the price action on the actual gold. You can see gold dropped around 20% from the highs from 7 August to March 12. And currently it's moving in this channel and it's at the low of the channel and you can see a kind of support formed here. This is one of my favorite setup for a swing trade. I buy this area with the marker indicator MACD and stochastic RSI showing an oversold state and I try to sell the high of the channel. On the gold case, it's around 1.9k. And now Barrick Gold dropped 40% from the highs and it's currently at 19.5. So it's pretty oversold. If you go on a weekly time frame, you can see the stock is pretty oversold and it's close to 200 moving average, which makes one of my favorite trading setup. The marker indicator is oversold, stochastic RSI, and the MACD indicator. So right here, it's a great buying opportunity. So I currently filled at 19.5 and I'm looking for a bounce back around $25 to $30 level. And if that happens, that's around 30-40% profit. Same thing with KL. On a weekly time frame, you can see the stock it's in this channel and it's at the low of the channel and close to 200 moving average, which is again oversold, and I'm looking for a bounce back around 40-60 level. And if that happens, that's around again 40-50% profit. So let me summarize everything. I just read on news the CEO of Barrick Gold is bullish on gold. So based on technical analysis, gold is at the low of the channel and I expect a bounce back around this level. If gold does this move, it's around 10%. And if gold goes up 10%, the mining companies will go 30-40%. And of course, if SPY help, it can go to 50%. So Barrick Gold, I bought 1,000 shares. My average is 19.5. I had some positions here and I averaged down right here. I expect a bounce back to $24 to $30 level. I look to cut losses around $15 area, which I don't think that's possible. I expect a bounce back even before dropping. So our job here is to get this one swing up. Same thing with KL, same analysis, they will usually go up and down the same time. KL have earnings at May 6 and I expect they perform good at the earnings. Now you're going to ask, why not buy gold instead of buying the mining companies? As a trading point of view, the mining companies will give me much better return than the actual gold price. And as I said, the mining companies are making much more profits than early 2020. Which the price is at the same level of the mining companies and gold price is much higher than early 2020. So if you understand the logic, you have much better risk-reward ratio on the mining company instead of gold, because the actual company is making more profits. So this is totally a personal opinion, and I may be wrong or correct. Trading is a game of probability. The more you increase your probability to win, the more you'll win in the market. And the more you're gambling, the more you lose. It's very simple. So hope you learned something new. See you in the next video.